give a warm welcome to the Reverend Gwendolyn Boyd.
Good morning, sorors and friends of Delta Sigma Theta. This is the day the Lord has made for Delta Sigma Theta, celebrating the centennial of the suffrage march. Good morning to everybody who is here. We welcome you as we continue the year-long celebration of the centennial of Delta Sigma Theta. And collectively with other organizations today, we will retrace the footsteps of our founders. All right, I need you with me this morning.
On January 13, 1913, they received their papers to become a chartered organization at Howard University called Delta Sigma Theta. 2 months after that, on this day, March 3, 1913, they participated in a suffrage march for women to get the right to vote, even before African Americans had the right to vote. But they were visionary women who were social activists in their own day and time. As undergraduate students, they had to get a chaperone to leave campus, because if you remember 100 years ago, we didn't have freedom of movement as we have it now. Delta Sigma Theta was the only African American organization that participated in the original suffrage march 100 years ago.
Bishop Vashti Murphy McKenzie, I am the presiding bishop of the 10th Episcopal District of the AME Church, and that's the great state of Texas.
I understand you have a connection to the parade 100 years ago. Could you describe that for us?
Well, my grandmother, Vashti Charlie Murphy, of course, was one of the 22 founders of Delta Sigma Theta sorority. At Howard University, she was a student, and she really believed in community service, and that's what our purpose is, our purpose in life. This is just an exciting day for us to be able to trace the footsteps of our founders, all of our founders, but it's just a great day for our family to be able to walk the same path that our grandmother walked.
I'm Paige Harrington, the director of the Sewell Belmont House and Museum.
I'm Elspeth Kirsch. I'm the Collections and Facilities Manager at Sewell Belmont.
Could you explain to viewers who don't know the history, how does what's happening here compare to what happened here 100 years ago?
The most striking difference between what's happening today and what happened 100 years ago is the calmness of the parade. 100 years ago, the parade wasn't a parade so much as a riot. The police refused to protect the marchers, and so as the marchers progressed down their planned parade route, the crowds got larger and larger. They were very unruly. They'd been drinking. They started to throw things at the women. They shouted things. They told them to go home, and a riot broke out. And not just that, streetcars continued to empty people into the already packed crowds. And so the crowd got larger and larger and more aggressive. And so the women couldn't go forward. The police weren't involved. In fact, the Secretary of Defense called out the Fort Myer Cavalry to push back the unruly crowd so that the women could continue their peaceful exercise of their First Amendment rights.
At the end of the day, over 100 women had to go to the hospital because of their injuries.
Mm-hmm. Whereas today, this is a wonderful, peaceful assembly and a celebration of how far we've come in 100 years.
Exactly.
This was the first time a civil rights parade occurred in Washington. And what's so remarkable about this is Alice Paul was down here with the delegation of NASA, which had been pushing for women's suffrage on a state-by-state right. basis. But what you see with this parade is the movement towards a push for a federal amendment to the Constitution. And it's the start of the real suffrage. It's the start of the movement that really drove us to the 19th Amendment, which gave women the right to vote.
The what? Majesty of the original parade was amazing. Inez Milholland rode on a white horse and led the marchers down Pennsylvania Avenue. There was a group of about 5,000 women that marched. And as Elspeth said, it quickly turned into a riot. And so the majesty of the afternoon was lost. So today we're celebrating, which is wonderful to be able to come together with so many women's organizations, including the Deltas, and become a part of this again today.